said.
Love and marriage, love and marriage. They go together like a horse and carriage. This I tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Love and Marriage Game Show. Please put your hands together for your cruise director, John Blair.
Show. Now this game show looks a heck of a lot like the Newlywed Game that you learned to love on television with Bob Eubanks a few years back. Now all of the questions that we're using tonight I actually took right from that television classic. So all of the questions were original Newlywed Game questions. Our twist, of course, we had people married a short time, folks that have been married a long time, fun people on stage tonight that simply want to have some laughs with us. We're kind of the opening act for the late night comedy show.
We look a lot alike.
Now, folks, I'm sure they're a little bit nervous. This room holds just a little over 1,600 people. We're pretty full right now. So when I introduce them to you, go wild and crazy. It goes a long way in helping them feel comfortable tonight. Guess what? They've been married for just a few days. Make a whole lot of noise for Ashley and Adrian. Married 54 years, Penny and Jerry. Let's have the ladies stand up, head to the soundproof booth. Ladies up to the soundproof booth, fellas, take a seat. Ladies are headed to the soundproof booth while the fellas are grabbing a seat.
Grandpa's on the stage with cherry pie playing.
All right. So here we go.
I never thought I'd seen this day.
Guys, we want to just let you know everybody really loves you, so let's just get a chance to meet you a little bit. Gene, where are you from?
We're from Utah, bountiful Utah.
We've got a lot of friends here tonight. Let me ask you a question. How did you first meet your lady there?
We met when I invited her to play tennis.
How did you know she played tennis?
She was good at it, and I was terrible at it.
What, you were watching her play someday, and you just said, let's get together and play tennis?
Well, it was actually a friend that introduced it. We went to the same high school, but she was a sophomore, and I was a senior, and we really didn't start dating until I was at the University of Utah, and she was still in high school. So.
Woo!
I got it. Where'd you go on the first date?
Oh, boy.
Play tennis. Play tennis, it makes total sense. Where was your first kiss?
In the closet.
Playing tennis, that's right. What's that?
I say in a car.
So we're really glad you're in the game. 54 years deserves a big round of applause. All right.
Austin, Texas.
Austin, what a great city that is. How did you first meet your lady?
At my birthday party.
At your birthday party? And so you somebody invited her to your birthday party?
No.
She just crashed your birthday party.
Nope.
That's it. All right, nice. Where'd you guys go on the first date?
Show me big boys.
And how was your first kiss? Where was it?
In front of Townsend Hall.
Nice. All right. Put that. I'm in the game. Where are you from, buddy?
I'm from Northern California.
California! Yeah. Oh, hey, how's your first date?
I was the best man at my friend's wedding.
She was at the wedding, you were the best man you met there at the wedding, and then you saw each other and you said, man, she's pretty.
Big time.
And where'd you guys go on the first date?
Ava Louie's Steakhouse.
Ava Louie's, yeah. And how about your first kiss? Where was it?
In the car, I believe.
Adrian, where are you from?
Detroit, Michigan.
How about your first kiss, your lady?
So, I met her at a Christmas party and then off Tinder again.
Off Tinder. What is that? What's that?
What is it? It's like an app on your phone. If you like the person, you swipe left. Or was it left or right?
What? I said, you know. These guys are tendering all over the place. Where was your first kiss?
It was on our first date. She took me out in her car to the lake. We just drank a lot, and we didn't even talk. We just made out the whole time.
So apparently that's a swipe left. All right.
All right, here we go. And guys, that was in the game when we started the game. Right now, we're going to start with a five-point question, the bonus question in this round for a 10-day question. We're going to start with you, Gene. Gene, what's the most ticklish part of Penny's body? Drives her crazy when you tip over there.
Whoa.
Her back.
That's how you tip over her back, Gene.
Last night.
Her
neck.
Last time you tickled her neck.
Last night.
Jay.
Her feet.
Last time you tickled her feet.
A month ago, maybe?
Adrian.
Back of her neck and before the show.
Yeah. So that was the kind of easy warm-up question. Well, we want you now to imagine yourself you're on a desert island. We left you there. You're all by yourself. You're so lonely. But you're not this lonely. You would not want to be with this person from your wife's side of the family. Adrian, who would you want to be with from Ashley's side of the family?
I hate her mom.
Oh, my gosh!
That was a rough one there. That was... There you go. Jay.
Father-in-law.
All right. It's nice. Al.
My dad's
together. You don't even know her name. We're all very close to their families. Gene, from Penny's side of the family, who would you not want to be with on a desert island?
Her brother.
What's his name?
Galen.
Galen?
Galen.
Galen. Galen, write it down. Galen, very nice. Guys?
That's the only person left.
Yeah, that's
You go to the store to pick your wife up an outfit, and you think you've done an absolutely incredible job, but guess what? Gals have expectation now. Shoes, handbags, shit, all kinds of stuff. Victoria's Secrets have now thrown you a real curveball, matching brassieres for outfits. You go to the store. Jay, you pick him up a brassiere. What size do you bring her home?
That's my mom.
To me.
Did he just say to me? Oh, yeah. Al.
34, double D.
Double D. That's because there's two of them. Yes. Your strategy to me. I get it now. Adrian!
I like boobs, but I think it's 4C.
4C.
Wow.
I didn't even like boobs. I like boobs.
They got to all have 4C.
Let me go on record as saying.
He's just squashed.
Jeez. Gene, what size brassiere would you bring home, Penny? 36C. 36C. Gene, do you like boobs? They're good. Ticklish part of Penny's body. What do you think he said?
Nothing.
He said it was your back. Your back, that's what he said. Can't give you a match there, but a lot of people get the first one wrong, and they come back strong. Nothing to worry about. Normal, most ticklish part of your body.
Is it everywhere?
He had a very specific spot.
My feet?
Your feet. He said your neck. A lot of people get the first one wrong, they come back strong, nothing to worry about. Kim?
My side?
Your sides. He said your feet. A lot of people get the first one wrong. No big deal. Ashley?
The top of my shoulders
is
like my neck.
Top of my shoulders? You're on the board now. So, yeah. So you guys are at the front right now, and you guys are all tied for second place. That's lovely. All right. Ashley, we left him on a desert island. Who would he not want to be with from your side of the family?
Oh, probably my sister.
What's her name?
Kayla.
No, he said your mom. He said your mom. Nice, she is nice. Yeah, he loves her. He really does. He loves every bit about her. Right? Here we go. What's that?
I sleep on the couch.
Folks, there's no big deal. Not nothing. Anyway, that was one of his better answers, by the way. Wait till you hear the next one. Who do you not want to be with from your side of the family?
My sister, Jennifer.
Your father.
No, he said your dad. That's right. Yeah. Can't give you a match there, but that's okay. A lot of people get the first two wrong. They're not strong. There's nothing to worry about. Normal, what did Al say? Who would want to be with this person on the desert island? By the way, it doesn't mean he doesn't like
my sister.
Your name?
Rosalind.
Rosalind. Write it down. It's Rosalind. Okay. Very good. Very good. Penny, who would you not want to be with?
Probably my mother.
Mom.
Your brother, Galen.
Galen. And that's some new stuff. By the way, again, a lot of people get the first two wrong. Alright, here we go. So everybody's kind of like, you know, just kind of doing okay. There's not a whole lot of points on the board right now, but that's okay, no big deal. 10-point question. We sent your guy to the store to pick you up a brassiere. What size does he bring? We're coming back to you anyway, don't worry about it. So here you go, I'm coming back to you. Nora, what size did Al bring you home?
Did he answer?
He did. He knew it right away. He was proud. I'm gonna come back. I'll come back. Hi, Norma. I'm back. How are you? Nice to see you. Missed you.
34 triple D.
I didn't even know they made triple D.
He said 34 double D.
He said double D. Double D. Clap for the song. What size would he bring you home?
I'm not sure that he would know that there is a number and a letter. So I'm going to go with extra large.
Extra large. Right. He said 2B, I think. A lot of people get the first three wrong. They come back strong. You guys, I've got my money on you, man. Can you believe that 2B? 2B. That's crazy, man. 2B.
34C.
He said 4C. So there you go. There you go. And then down here to the end. Oh, it's Patty. Patty, what size brassiere would Gene bring you home?
I don't think he can find one. Probably.
What'd you say, Gene?
I said we can find hers.
Oh.
Thirty-six feet.
He said. 36C. It's really, really, really close. I can't actually give it to you, but that's okay. Don't worry about it. Again, a lot of people get the first three wrong, and we're back at this game. Give me some music. Ladies, grab your seat. Proud to take a shot. There you go. Take care, ladies. Grab a seat. All right.
Grandma don't remember anything.
No. Okay, we like the fellas. Give you guys a big round of applause. Would you please, guys? All we want to know, ladies, what is your... They're guys. Let's face it. They're fellas. We just want to know, what is your fellas' most annoying habit? It bugs you about Gene, Penny.
He chews his fingernails.
Fingernail chew. Norma, most annoying habit of owls.
He doesn't have any annoying habits.
Wow. Nothing. Is that nothing? Kim?
Really
bad,
no
answer. But you're having a hard time picking one. I'm going to go with...
He forgets to put the toilet seat down.
Wow. That's pretty close to nothing, quite frankly. That's probably almost every guy in this room, actually. Ashley?
Talking about himself.
What's the problem about himself?
Talking about himself, looking at himself. Always.
Loves himself.
Loves himself.
He's probably back here right now, kind of pruning him up.
He's fixing his hair.
Right, so he kind of talks about himself a little bit, right? Does he ever get, be honest now, does he ever get made get in front of you, dance around, try to get you in the mood?
Oh, yeah.
You know he does. When you look at his body, do you see Superman, Woody Woodpecker, or Pee-wee Herman?
Superman.
Superman, yeah. Superman, Woody Woodpecker, or Pee-wee Herman?
Superman.
You got it. Superman, Woody Woodpecker, or Pee-wee Herman?
Definitely Superman.
You got it. Superman, Woody Woodpecker, Pee-wee Herman?
Pee-wee
Penny just doesn't care anymore, people. Here we go. For 25 points, Bob Eubanks wrote this for the original game show. All we want to know, and not Bob Eubanks' answer, your answer. Ladies, strangest, most unique place you and your fella ever made whoopee. Kim? Don't start with you? All right. Let me start with you. We'll start right here. Norma? Show Rich, lead her the way. Strangest, most unique place, you and I. She's apparently got a lot to think about.
On the beach.
Yeah. I believe we went to a beach today, people. Kid. Put a car in the driveway. What kind of car? I'm curious.
A silver one.
I'd like to buy a silver car. That was kind of in the next room. Alright, that's okay.
No.
Hey! You ready for this? 54 years
old. I hope it's at your house.
Yeah.
Strangest, most unique place, Penny. Who are you traveling with, Penny?
13 grandkids.
Yeah! What are they going to do when they find out you're in this game show?
They're all my kids.
They're here!
We're videoing!
Oh, you kids are going back to find out what freaks Grandma and Grandpa really are. Strangest, most unique place here, Penny.
The front seat of a triumph.
Wow. Well, I thought for sure this was going to be an RV rocking joke.
It was a blue car. Triumph Spitfire, right? Is that what they call them? Nice, that's a cool car, man. It's a sports car. That's lovely.
Is that Seducer?
Give me some music. Let's bring in the fellas. Here we go. Look at Penny, she's like she won the prize already. Grandma really is having a great cruise, isn't she? Hey guys, go stand behind you, ladies, and let's get this question started. You guys are too funny, man. Get down here. Gene, we love you. Gene, you're awesome. Gene, isn't he great? Gene's just great. Gene, we just said, what's your most annoying habit? It kind of bugs your wife.
Chewing my nails.
Yeah. Gene, you are on the board, Gene. Al, most annoying habit.
Touching my face.
No, she said you knew nothing. Everything about you is absolutely perfect. Yeah. No. I can't give you points, but you should be a happy man right now. Jay, your wife did not say that, by the way.
She's not a fan when I leave the toilet seat up.
Adrian.
There's two that I think. One is by looking in the mirror too much, and the other one is I talk about myself.
That's what she said. Hey man, you ever think you're the best part of trying to get her to move? Yes, you do. Give me some music. Let's see you. Let's go. Let's you and Gene are going to be in a nightclub later today. Your wife's looking at your body. Does she see Superman, Woody Woodpecker, or Pee-wee Herman?
Superman.
You got it, man. Superman, Woody Woodpecker, Pee-wee Herman.
Superman.
You got it. Superman, Woody Woodpecker, Pee-wee Herman.
Superman.
You got it. Superman, Woody Woodpecker, Pee-wee Herman.
Superman.
It's a match. You're on the board, baby. Yeah. Penny, you owe me. We're not messing up this relationship over this stupid game show. 25-point bonus question. Strangest, most unique place you and your lovely wife have ever made, Whoopi. We'll rent you out. We love you guys, by the way. Nice couple. Give them a big round of applause. Strangest, most unique place is the actual question.
In the car line at the restaurant.
No, she didn't say that. She said the beach. Remember the beach?
That's not strange.
Jay.
Silver. Balcony of the cruise ship.
Balcony!
real close to it today. Now I know why. Can't give you that there, but I like your answer a whole lot. She said the hood of a car, but I like your answer better. Well, strangest place you need to place. Nice people. Well, not nice people, aren't they nice people? Nice kids here, very cool. So, buddy, strangest most unique place.
Wouldn't call it unique, but porta potty.
No!
Yeah, man. Well, she said the dad's bathroom. Now, if dad's bathroom is a porta potty, you're getting the match, man.
First time.
That was the first, okay. You guys,
the first time was in the dad's bathroom.
You guys, an issue. That's right. Problem. Right. Give him a big round of applause, man. Thank you. All right, man. 54 years of marriage. We got like 90 grandkids out there right now. They're all out there, man. All right, they're gonna learn something right now about you. Strangest, most unique place you and your lovely wife have ever made, Whoopi.
Behind the Utah State Capitol at Memory Grove.
This silly game show. We think they're all winners simply by coming up here and helping us have some laughs.
That's so
How
great.
How about you give them all a big round of applause? Coming right on up. Don't go anyplace. Grab some drinks. We're going to be right back with some more comedy. Thanks, everybody.